Hi, I'm Eric Schmidt, and this is Video Voters Guide, a service of the League of Women Voters, a 102-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For more election information, be sure to visit our online site, vote411.org, before you mark your ballot. Today we have Kevin Barton, who is a candidate for the Washington County District Attorney's position. Mr. Barton, thank you for joining us, and we might add that not only are you a candidate, you are the incumbent district attorney in Washington County. Please tell us a little bit about yourself and why you're seeking a second term.
Thank you, Eric. Good to be here, and it's good to talk once again. I am the current district attorney in Washington County, and I've worked in the DA's office here for the past 15 years. This is a community that I've really grown up in, and I'm raising my family here as well. My wife and I, we live in Washington County. We've got three kids that are all attending Washington County schools. I first came to the DA's office as a young prosecutor because I really believed in the mission of what we do, which is quite simply keeping our community safe. And we do that by prosecuting criminals, by protecting victims, and now as DA, I've included pursuing responsible reforms as we make our criminal justice system work for everyone. When I was first elected in 2018 and ran in that contested election, I was blown away by the amount of community support that I had, and I won that race by almost 40 points with a very clear mandate from the people, which is that people wanted Washington County to remain a safe community. And I've pursued and really met that mandate from the people here over the past 4 years. And I'm very proud of the work that we've done. We are the safest large county in Oregon. Our crime rate is 30% lower than the state average, and it's a whopping 50% lower than the crime rate in neighboring Multnomah County. But that's not to say that we don't have challenges. We have a lot of challenges in Washington County that we're working to address. Issues with mental health that we're dealing with, issues with addiction rising in our community, issues with limited resources as we try and meet the needs of a growing community, and frankly, issues with crime bleeding over into Washington County from neighboring Portland. I'm very pleased to have the experience as a prosecutor and also the trust of our community with endorsements from a wide variety of leaders throughout the community, including all of our police chiefs and police associations, 11 of our current and former mayors, and numerous Democrats and Republicans, because I believe the work in the DA's office is nonpartisan, and the DA should meet the needs of everyone in our community. And I've done that in my time here, and I want to continue doing that to keep our community safe.
Thank you. What should be the district attorney's role in dealing with the inadequate number of public defenders?
Well, let me start by saying I absolutely believe that there's a problem when it comes to the way our public defense system is managed and funded and how it's working. There's a big problem that needs to be addressed. The district attorney is not part of the public defense system by design. In fact, the DA and the public defenders, we go head to head in court, and that's the way our system is set up to be functioning. Nevertheless, the DA plays a key role in making sure that the public safety system and the criminal justice system functions well. Think of it like the engine in your car with so many different moving parts. The DA has a primary responsibility to help make sure that those moving parts work well together so the car can function. I think that right now what we're dealing with is a public defense system that's not functioning well. And there's a state agency whose primary and statutory obligation is to make sure that it functions. And that agency is called Oregon Public Defense Services, OPDS. They are not meeting their duty right now, and they should be held accountable for that failure to meet that duty. Now, whether the answer is more money, more resources, or better management, I don't know all the answers for what is happening with that state agency, but I do know that our presiding judge here in Washington County recently issued an order that if they aren't able to make sure that people who are accused of crimes have defense attorneys representing them, then there's a possibility that that agency might be held in contempt of court. And I think that making sure that that agency meets its burden is the first and necessary step to ensuring that our justice system continues to work.
Who should investigate complaints of excessive force by law enforcement agencies in Washington County?
Well, investigation and prosecution are really two sides of a coin. And so I believe that the police should be investigating it, but you cannot have the same police officers who are being investigated. You cannot have people in that same agency conduct the investigation. In Washington County, we have had for years now a very strict policy of ensuring that there's some level of separation. So when we have a police officer who, let's say, uses deadly force, such as an officer-involved shooting, we have a Washington County major crimes team which comes out and conducts that investigation. But we do not allow officers from the same agency where the shooter officer is employed to be part of that investigation. That's different. It's a different approach than, for example, happens in Multnomah County or in some other neighboring counties. But we have believed that having that level of separation is critical to ensuring that you have a good investigation and an investigation that people can rely on.
Who should make the decision about whether or not a law enforcement officer who serves in Washington County should be prosecuted for a death as the result of their duty, their actions on duty?
Well, this is a very important issue. At the end of the day, when police officers use deadly force against someone in our community, we want to make sure that that decision to use deadly force is a lawful and appropriate decision. The way Oregon law is currently set up, every county has what's called a plan, a protocol for how these situations are going to be addressed. And in Washington County, our plan has been approved by all of the city councils and the county commissioners to ensure that we have our major crimes team conduct the investigation. And then the district attorney actually reviews the results of the investigation to determine whether or not the use of deadly force was lawful or legitimate. I think this should change. And in fact, I have called for there to be a change to this plan. And in fact, last year, we had a shooting where I actually asked the Attorney General's office to come in and review the shooting. I think our current process is lawful and is just and is fundamentally sound. But I also think that it can be better. I think that it would promote greater confidence in our community to have a totally separate and independent body conduct not only the investigation, but also the review of the police shooting. And so we've thought about and explored different options, including asking a neighboring district attorney's office to come in and review the results of a shooting, or, as I mentioned a moment ago, having the attorney general, an entirely different elected official, come in and review the results of that shooting. But ultimately, in order to effect a change in how this occurs, the law would need to change, and the legislature would need to change that law and also provide for the resources so that another body could come in and do that. And I support having those conversations and making some of those changes.
A lot of people with mental health issues, behavioral health issues, end up in jail charged with crimes that are of a minor nature by and large. Should those people be in treatment or should they be prosecuted for the crimes that they committed?
The short answer is it really depends. A person who is committing a crime and also has a mental health issue still can be a danger and a threat to public safety. So a person with a mental health issue and a knife or a gun or another weapon can cause a great risk to public safety. A person with a mental health issue who commits sex crimes can cause a great risk to public safety. The system is set up so that we ensure that we deal with people with mental health issues and make sure that they are fit to stand trial, and also make sure that we are addressing the underlying mental health issue that might be at play. But there are many, many people with mental health issues that do not present a threat to public safety. People who might be committing lower level public order type offenses. And in that scenario, those people don't necessarily need to go through the criminal justice system. But at the same time, we need to make sure that those people get the treatment and the services to address that underlying mental health issue that they might have. And actually, for that reason, just 2 months ago, I started a brand new program in Washington County, and it's called our Mental Health Diversion Program. And what we're doing in that program is we're taking people that do have documented mental health issues, but they commit low-level crimes that don't present a public safety threat. So they're not hurting someone with a weapon or hurting someone who might be a vulnerable victim, but instead they're committing public order type crimes. And when we have people who are in that scenario that don't present a public safety threat, we can use the tools that the criminal justice system has to make sure they get the treatment that they need. But at the end of the case, we can dismiss or reduce the charge so that we're not putting another burden on that person with a mental health issue, another record on their criminal history. So at the end of the day, they can hopefully be productive members of our community. And I think having programs like that, where we try and address underlying root cause issues so that we can avoid seeing that person again and again and again in the system, those programs will pay dividends. And we in Washington County have been a statewide leader at specialty courts and treatment programs just like that.
I wish we had more time. Kevin Barton is a candidate for Washington County District Attorney. Thank you, Mr. Barton, for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
And voters, don't forget to visit Vote411 for complete candidate and ballot measure information, and be sure to vote.